She's dangerous, she's fun, and she's the cleverest of the bunch.
Now, some of you may have seen us before on TV, and some of you may have seen us online, but we are much better live. What about you, though? Can you cheer? That's good. Can you scream? Can you boo? Oh, come on, you can do better than that. Can you boo? Brilliant. Well, brace yourself for more thrills and spills. More primes and bangs. We've got stuff you've never seen before. This is fresh from the lab. High risk, untried, untested, unapproved for public viewing. In other words, dangerous. If you don't like loud noises, there's plenty to do outside. But in here, it's gonna get loud. Do you like it loud, Minehead? Okay, here it goes. Throughout the history of the universe, cartoon characters have been running through things. Bugs Bunny, SpongeBob, Scooby-Doo. They all know a thing or two about things you can run through and things you can't. But here at Braniac, we don't like to leave it up to our cartoon character friends when it comes to running through things. We like to do it for real. Take a look at this. This is a wood and metal frame. It's built to withstand a high impact collision. Thanks, Dave. I built it myself. It took me 2 weeks of hard grafting. It's a combination of pine and pay, actually. But this will not break. However, the fun doesn't start until we add this. This is wallpaper. Tell us about it, Braniac Ed.
Paper is made from a cellulose pulp derived from wood, rags, or grasses. It's used in packaging, printing, even insulation. Now, it's strong, but it don't like getting wet.
We're gonna find out if wallpaper is one of the things you can run through. Okay, I've got this lovely yellow helmet here that should keep me nice and safe. Health and safety is very important here at Braniac.
What are you thinking, Braniac, Ned?
You know what, Ed? It's only paper. But the brick print is a little bit distracting because it's so brilliant.
What's your plan?
I'm just gonna run at it really fast.
Genius!
Okay, so for this, I am gonna need a little bit of help. So, will you help me? Come on, will you help me with this? Good. If I make it through the wallpaper, I need everybody to go absolutely crazy wild and make as much noise as we can. But first, we all need to put both hands in the air because we're gonna do a Braniac clap. We all need to put both hands in the air. You're in the middle at the front, come on. You don't wanna do it, sit in the back. Come on! We're gonna do a Braniac clap. It goes like this. Good, nice and loud. Great job. Okay. Ooh, I gotta move this. It's a bit weird running up to something that looks like a brick wall, but let's face it. It's easy to get through.
Well, I mean, paper is measured by its bursting strength. Things like, I don't know, paper bags need to be really strong. And you, just like Bugs Bunny, burst right through that wall.
Brilliant, straight through wallpaper. Okay, would you like another one? All right then, let's see if the next item is one of the things you can run through. Whoa, wait a second, I know this stuff. This is plasterboard. Isn't this the stuff walls are actually made of?
Yes. Plasterboard is made from a sheet of gypsum plaster, practically 2 thick sheets of paper. It's made of 75% calcium sulfate and 25% water. And in theory, it's built to withstand a huge amount of force.
What does that mean in English, though, Raz?
It's gonna really
say that. Okay. I don't know about this, guys. What do you think? Should I give it a go? All right, then. Remember, if I make it through, nice and loud. But first, let's put those hands in the air. Let's do that Braniac clap. Are you not going to do it? I'm going to do it. Come on, do it once. Go on. Just once. Dad, come on. Come on, Dad. Come on. Let's do it.
Excited? This Braniac is clever. He wants to have some fun while blowing things up. And this Braniac, well, I'd keep an eye on that one. Tends to be the loudest. Bangs come in three sizes. Blimey, oh blimey, and are those my teeth over there? Which balloon do you think is the loudest? Well, Let's see. Fingers in ears. That balloon is full of hydrogen. Hydrogen is a chemical element with atomic number 1. It is represented by the simple H, and although relatively rare on Earth, it does account for roughly 75% of the universe's chemical elemental mass. Oh, very good. A sizable bang there. Well done. Moving on now, another bang coming. Fingers back in your ears. Next balloon. A combination 1/3 air, 2/3 hydrogen. Air has a lot of nitrogen in it. Nitrogen, atomic number 7. Lucky for some. Symbol N, clearly there on the balloon. N for nitrogen. Yes! A great bang there. The combination is the key. The air makes the hydrogen very angry. An angry gas is loud gas. Very good indeed. Last of the balloons now. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oxygen and hydrogen together. Now this will be loud. A small balloon, but a very volatile combination. Fingers are most definitely in ears. Oxygen, atomic number 8, represented by the symbol O. Oh, no, this will be big. Oh! Yes! A fantastic bang there! Big round of applause for our boom bang a bang Braniac.
Traveling circus came. They brought an intelligent elephant, and Nelly was her name. One dark night, she slipped her iron chain, and off she ran to Hindustan and was never seen again. Nelly the elephant went back to jump and said goodbye to the circus. Off she went with the trumpety trump, 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 trump. Nelly the elephant went back to jump and trundle back to the jungle.
Okay, Butlins, are you still with us?
Good. Over the years, there have been many amazing inventors. Steve Jobs invented the iPhone.
Yeah.
Maria Beasley invented windscreen wipers. And Hedy Lamarr. Now, she was one of the female minds behind the invention that provided the foundation for GPS, Bluetooth, and Wi-Fi.
Oh, speaking of Wi-Fi, do you have the internet code? I haven't been able to get on Instagram on it. You don't have it? They don't give it to you? Sorry. Yeah, inventors. Okay, I know a few. Let me think. James Watt. He invented the steam engine. Yeah?
Choo-choo.
Then there was Alexander Graham Bell. He invented... We know what he invented, right? Yeah, the telephone, of course. But my favourite inventor of all time, Raz, has to be Joseph Gacy. Do you know why?
No idea.
Because he invented the coolest thing ever. Toilet paper. We all love toilet paper.
Well, there is one inventor I want to tell you about today.
Okay.
He was a real brainiac. His name was Thomas Wilson.
Thomas Wilson, okay.
He managed to create a bright white light from a chemical reaction that was used to light homes, on miners' helmets, and even car and bike lights.
Raz, he wasn't that clever though, was he? Because you could just go down to Halfords and get a bike light off the shelf for 20 quid.
This is back in the late 1800s, so long before you could just nip down the shops and get some batteries. Anyway, check this out. This is a lamp that miners would wear on their helmets when heading down the mines. They put a chemical into the bottom of it, drip water into it, and then light it on fire.
What, on their heads? Are they nuts?
Probably. Now, I'm going to show you how this is done today, and then I'm going to need your help.
I love helping experiments.
The secret to this is inside this container here, and it's called calcium carbide. The chemical formula for this is CaC2.
CaC2. Got it.
Now, when we add water to calcium carbide, it releases acetylene gas. What's it called?
Acetylene gas.
And this is a chemical reaction.
Ooh, haha. Yeah, but it's a danger.
and this is the acetylene gas being released. Did you know that acetylene gas is used today in things like cutting and welding? Because it burns at over 3,000 degrees.
3,000 degrees, that is hot.
Yes. Right, let's do the experiment. We've got water in the container, you're going to add the calcium carbide rocks, then I'm going to light it. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's do this. So calcium carbide going in, the acetylene gas is being released, and...
Whoa! Great job. I mean, that's fun, it's cool, but... It didn't last very long, did it?
I know, it's not very impressive when we show it like this, but check this out. This is an ordinary plastic bottle, and I've made a small hole in the back of it. It's got water in it, and once again, I want you to add calcium carbide.
Okay.
Hey, if we use my bandana to plug the top of the bottle, that's going to build up the pressure inside, and if we get this right, my bandana will shoot straight up in the air. Should we give it a go?
Yeah.
Let's do it. So calcium carbide going in, mixes with the water at the bottom, and then I'm going to plug the top with my bandana like this. Now get ready, everybody, because this is
going to
be loud!
Hey! Oh, I got it!
Yeah!
Okay, that is pretty cool. You're right. You know we would love to see this, and we would have so much fun with it. Braniac again.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to go and tell him.
Ed,
you have got to see this. We need to do something.
Unbelievable. I was in the basement of Braniac HQ yesterday and I came up with a little something. Do you not want to see it? Do you want to see it? Well, in that case, bring on the rockets! Yeah! Check this out! So, in the bottom of each of these tubes is water. Once again, we're going to add the calcium carbide. That's going to release the acetylene gas. Then we just need something to plug the top of each of the tubes.
Earlier, Ed asked me to do his washing, but I didn't quite get around to the socks, and maybe we could use them.
Great idea! Okay, we're going to start adding the calcium carbide into the top of each rocket. That's mixing with the water at the bottom and releasing that acetylene gas. Then we're going to plug the top of each bomb with Ed's socks. I cannot wait for this! You know what the best thing is about these rockets? They don't just launch straight up into the air.
No.
We can actually set them forwards so we can fire them at the audience!
Ha ha! Alright, let's get a countdown going, Raz. Here we go.
Fingers in is 3, 2, 1.
But that t-shirt, yeah, that's going to be £12.
He's only joking. Big round of applause for calcium carbide!
Calcium carbide! Our day, even in an office. Take a look at this. This is an office chair. Not much happens in them. People sit in them, they write emails, make phone calls. Some people even fall asleep. You know what I'm talking about, right? But that's all boring stuff. This is Braniac Live. Today we're going to find out what's the best way to spin an office chair. Up to you, Braniac Ed.
Okay, we're going to need 15 seconds on the clock and we're going to need your help. The clock will start, Braniac Ed will start to spin. Now every time he passes this point, shout out and we'll count how many he can do. Are you up for it? Minehead, are you up for it? Right, get the clock up. Get you ready?
Yes.
On my count, nice and loud. 3, 2, go. Right, that's one. Oh, for the love of... Give me some welly neck.
I'm not wearing welly neck.
Just keep counting.
I've never worked in an office.
Yeah, I can tell.
Here, here, and here.
do you want to do it? There's so many stuff.
Yeah, I want to start.
Don't just, do you want to do it? They're all here, I'm here.
Oh, don't put this pressure.
Hey, come on. What do you think?
They're all watching.
Yeah. Stay loud, be proud, and I'll see you soon at another Braniac Live. Bye-bye.